class. Good morning from Bangkok to the training course funded by Thailand International Cooperation Agency on the topic of training to enhance manufacturing technology and green productivity in rice mill factory, organized by Office of Industrial Economics in collaboration with National Food Institute under the Ministry of Industry of Thailand. Today is 29 January 2021. With the 25 degree Celsius in Bangkok. We hope that all colleagues and participants around the world stay in good health and safe mode. For today's activities, we will have the topic of value added in rice mill. There are two lectures to be with us today. In the first one, we will learn about the value added in rice mill for product development. And later on, we will learn for value added in rice mill for packaging development. Our program of activities today will be continuously without any break. So, we ask for time collaboration for all colleagues and participants to be patient with us and actively joining us for today's activities. After the lecture, there will be a wrap up activities and posted with evaluation from Taiga and OIE. Now, let's move to the first lecture for today on value added in rice mill product development. Still continue because the previous lecture, Ms. Purita Pananan, the consultant from National Food Institute. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Please welcome Ms. Purita Pananan. Good morning, Ms. Purita.
Okay, good morning, everyone. Hi, greeting. Hi, say, don't say, you have to say hello. In general, we are different in many times, time zone, right? Hello. Okay, are you ready for knowing about the technique, food technology to develop the rice to have more value added? So today is not, is more relaxed than yesterday. We're gonna take that you have to, like to share experience for to others. It's not much teaching like yesterday, okay? Okay. Okay, ready. For the first, shall we start? Okay. Okay. For the first, I have to show that how about food processing. The food processing is any method used to turn fresh fruits into food products. This can involve one or a combination of various processes, including washing, chopping, not chopping, right? Chopping is like how to use a knife, right? Pasteurizing, freezing, fermenting, packing, cooking, and many more processes. Food processing also includes product development by adding ingredients to food like preservative or colorization, or changing the packaging, for example, to extend shelf life for more interest and more value. Okay, for the objective of the food processing has six objectives of food processing. The first one is to preservation, like to extending shelf life process, extend the shelf life as all the processes like dehydration, cold storage, canning and pasteurization, or aim at preservation of food, preventing the food from getting spoiled for longer time, thus increasing digestibility. The second one is to be safe for consumption. Making food safe for consumption. Food sometimes contain toxins which are harmful to health. These toxins need to be inactivated. For example, trypsin inhibitor in soybeans, fungal toxin such as aflatoxin in moldy groundnuts and grains can be removed by visual examination. Use of the processes which remove toxins and heat to be to destroy the microorganisms and their toxins. The third objective, to be more variety of food products. Enhance flavor, color, taste. The acceptability of food depends to the large extent on its organoleptic or sensory qualities. Processing techniques enhance the appearance of food, and many techniques make food more appetizing and tasty, such as caramelization of sugar fermentation better, and alcoholic fermentations produce superior taste as compared to the unprocessed food. Fourth, to make more easy for consumption. Increasing digestibility, most foods are difficult to digest unless they are cooked. Cooking softened fiber, gelatinize the starch, denature proteins, make the food easier to digest, and improve texture and consistency processes such as emulsification, aeration, gel formation, and increase in viscosity are aimed at improving the texture and consistency of ready-to-eat, cook and chill, freeze operation. Processing prevents changes in consistency of such operation during freezing thaw process. Crystal food and disabled texture can be obtained. Fifth, it's more easy for storage, transportation, and store of food. And the last one for the objective of the process of food processing is the main point is for value added to the food product. Increasing acceptability through fabricated food, new products of uniform size, shape are being introduced in the market, which is good for health. Health drinks is like aloe vera juice is, or milk juice, rice drinking is blended with tastier substance so as to increase the acceptability. Availability of ready-to-eat foods, extruded food is also because of food processing techniques that help in food, new food product development. Do you guys agree with this main objective for food processing? Do you have any idea that the objective for food processing is more than this sixth one? Okay, it's too fast. No, good, okay. It's okay. Okay, this for example of product development, that's just the packaging and the printing and the coloring for the packaging. This for is the simplest way to develop for added the value to the product. The first one is tomato juice. The first one is the tomato juice, the old design, which is already or is red, right? But the new one, you has the printing has all fresh tomato. Inside is referred to that the product made from fresh tomato. More interested or more tasty, right? The next one is tomato paste ketchup. Yeah. The packaging will be changed to the upside down packaging that's for easy to squeeze and use. Same as the sweetened condensed milk. Yeah. Even can, okay, it's longer use, but not easy for using. Change the company will change to the tube one that you can easy to squeeze and use more than the old one. Again, you see? Clear for the example. But for more detail about the packaging will be in the next part after my presentation, okay? Okay, for the first one. That I will show you. This is a main byproduct from the rice meal, right? Bran. Download material. Okay, wait a minute for the material. Okay, can I be next? Okay. The manual, okay, will be post. Okay. Via email. Already sent to mail to participants. Okay, next is for the rice bran. Rice bran is one of the main byproducts in the process of the rice milling. It is the outer brown layer of brown rice and is separated during the milling process. It contains various antioxidants that impart beneficial effects on human health. A major rice bran function contains 12 to 13% oil. It is also processing byproduct which accounts of tons of food waste per year from the milling, composed by numerous nutrient bioactive substance that are able to reduce risk of non-communicable chronic disease. Therefore, rice bran can be considered as good candidate as a sustainable function ingredient. For non-communicable chronic disease such as the heart disease, hypertension, and diabetes, that is called the non-communicable chronic, which is the disease that don't happen from the germ, from the virus, it's from the malfunction of the body. For the chemical composition of the rice bran consists of phytochemical proteins, dietary fiber, and minerals are some of the components. As consequences from food applications have been proposed for rice bran. The uses. For normally bran is often used to enrich bread like muffins and breakfast cereal, especially for the benefit of those wishing to increase the intake of dietary fiber. Bran may also be used for pickling in Japanese food, like in the picture. In the picture, Japanese pickling vegetable. Rice bran is particularly fine mainly used in Japan, where it is known as nuka, right, in the picture. Besides of using for pickling, Japanese also add it into water when boiling a bamboo shoot and use it for dish washing. Rice bran is stuck to the surface of the commercial white for block to prevent of from melting of ice. Bran oil may be also extract for use by itself for industrial purposes, such as in the for the food industry, like cooking oil, such as rice bran oil. For rice bran oil, as is kind of the popular cooking oil, rice bran oil is extracted from the germ and the inner husk of rice. It is notable for its high smoke point and mild flavor, making it suitable for high temperature cooking methods such as stir frying and deep frying. What's more, eating rice bran oil helps lower cholesterol, fight diseases, enhance the immune system, and fight free radical and more. Rice bran oil manufacturing process mainly include rice bran expelling, extraction, and refining. This video is show how to produce the rice bran oil with the cold press method. all we get to prove what is going on. Not the time, not the time. But the situation of the world that we have to do is not what we call the world. All we have to do is what we can do. This is the how to manage the byproduct, the main byproduct from rice milling. And another example for evaluated the byproduct is the rice that broken or broken rice or unqualified rice. Yield is to be the animal feeding and become a fertilizer, bio fertilizer. Okay, from Miss the Senegal, Ibrahima. Okay, I will send you the answer by the email for more detail. Okay, thank you for your patience. And another one is live flour. Live flour is made by grinding whole kernel or the from the broken rice that from the processing of food of rice milling again, the unqualified rice. The rice flour varies widely based on the type of rice, how it works, milling is what meal and the starch content. It depends on the variety of the rice. Rice flour is also mean to glutinous life form. While rice flour or wild rice or sticky life form may commonly use include gluten-free baking, it has neutral flavor and white color, can be digested easily, and is considered hypoallergenic. Gluten-free dough made with rice flour will resemble and matter more than the dough. Okay. Okay. For the origin, first, okay, rice flour, I will more explain about the origin of rice flour. Rice flour is very common in parts of the world where rice is a staple ingredient. Thai, China, Indonesia, Bangladesh have the highest level of rice consumption and use of its flour. In 1980s, it was introduced to the Western world, where it became a primary ingredient in many processed foods in the baking industry. Of the world's total rice production is about 90% in ground and consuming in India. For function of rice flour, rice flour is used as an alternative to wheat flour in gluten-free baked goods. Bread produced from it may have lower loaf volume, harder texture, and short shelf life. It is important to use it in combination with other flour, starch, gum, and enzyme to help mimic in the gluten matrix. Using rice flour with these ingredients will remove water absorption. It was water absorption about 50% based on dough weight. Higher water absorption level indicate a dough that is more elastic. Adding hydrochloride at about 2% to rice flour formula has shown increase in water absorption. For the nutrition of the rice flour is high in fiber, gluten-free, and low in saturated fat, cholesterol, and sodium. It has rare nutritional value than whole grain rice or whole grain brown rice flour, but it is a significant source of the magnesium in around, and it has around 10% protein, 80 carbohydrates, and around 7% fat. Rice flour is enriched in with vitamin and mineral to meet nutrient requirement. For the commercial product, rice is the first to hull, after which it tempered and milled to remove its bran. Then the enrich of the table rice, but not for rice flour production unless the requirement by customer. There are several milling options available, yielding different part size, texture, and starch content. The process of particle boiling is used to produce more nutrients variety. The process entails soaking the rice, then heating and drying it after or before it is dehulled. During the parboil processing, thiamine migrates from the rice to pericarp into the endosperm. And the different type that are three different types, two or three different types for being grinding to the to produce the rice flour. The first one is wet grinding. It's the most traditional and it most expensive process for obtaining rice flour. Wet grinding results in significantly smaller average particle size and a lower percentage of starch damage than alternative grinding method. The second one is semi-dry. Semi-dry grinding. It is simpler than the wet one. Rice kernels are soaked and dried before they are grinded into flour. The method is expensive and time consuming. And for the extra one, it's called freeze grinding. Freeze grinding is a new method that use the less energy and produce less waste from the processing. Rice kernel are frozen using liquid nitrogen and then dry ground into flour. Freeze grinding temperature have been shown to damage starch content in the rice flour. Okay, the next part, or the first part, is all about how to manage the waste one or the byproduct one from the rice milling. The next part will be using the technology for processing for more value added to the rice product. The first one is thermal process, chilling and freezing technology, drying, fermentation, and cooking method like homemade cooking. Like you can do it by yourself, not waste the rice that you use or eat. Okay. For the first one is thermal process technology. Thermal processing involve heat the heating food either in a sealed container or by passing through the heat exchanger, followed by packaging. It is important to ensure that the food is adequately heat treated and to reduce post-processing contamination. The food should then be cooled quickly, and it may require the refrigerated storage or be stable at ambient temperature according to your methods. The heating process can be either batch or continuous. It's all thermal process. The aim should be heat and cool the product as quickly as possible. This has economic implications and may also lead to an improvement in quality. The heating medium is usually saturated steam or hot water for temperature about 100 degrees Celsius. Steam and hot water are above atmospheric pressure. In the process of cooling is achieved using either main water, chilled water, brine or glycol solution. Regeneration in use is continuous process to further reduce energy utilization. For the reason of the heating, food are heated for a number of reasons. The main one being to inactivate pathogenic microorganism and also spoiled microorganism. It may also be important to inactivate enzymes to avoid the browning, like the browning of fruit by polyphenol oxidized, and minimize flavor changes result from like base and protein or lytic activity. For safety and quality issues, the two most important issues connected with thermal processing are food safety and food quality. The major is the safety issue. The safety issue involved in actuating pathogenic microorganisms, which are of public health concern. The World Health Organization estimates that there are over 100 million cases of food poisoning each year, and that 1 million of these result in death. These pathogens show considerable variation in their heat resistance, some inactivated by pasteurization, while the of greater heat resistant, which may survive in pasteurization and also grow at low temperature. The most heat resistant pathogenic bacterial spore, like Clostridium botulinum in canned food, as well as the major foodborne pathogens, it is important to inactivate those microorganisms in which cause food spoilage, such as yeast, molds, and gas-producing and soaring bacteria. Again, there is considerable variation in their heat. The most heat-resistant being the spore of Bacillus cereus, for example. Anyway, heat resistant and any microorganism change at environmental change, for example, pH, the water activity, or chemical composition change, and food themselves provide such as complex and variable environment also. The next, the second one, the first one is safety issue, but the second one is for quality issues. The quality issues revolve around minimizing chemical reactions and loss of nutrition and ensuring that sensory characteristics like appearance, color, flavor, and texture are acceptable to the consumer. Quality changes, which may result from enzyme activities, must also be considered. There are also be conflict between safety and quality issue for a little bit. For example, microbial inactivation and food safety is increased by more severe heating condition, but product quality in general deteriorates. To summarize, it is important to understand the reaction of the kinetic and how they relate to the microbial inactivated chemical chain damage and enzyme inactivation and physical change. The appearance means everything that you can see on in the product, right? Color, texture, something like that. For microbial inactivation, for more explain about it, all thermal process involve three distinct periods. One is the heating period, holding period, and cooling period. In theory, all three periods may contribute to the reaction taking place, although the situation where heating and cooling are rapid, the holding period is the most significant. However, procedures are needed to evaluate each of these periods to determine that the overall effect. By far of the easiest to deal with is the holding period, and this takes place at constant temperature. Then it needs to be estimated how reaction rates are affected by changes in the temperature during heating and cooling. To simplify, the analysis, microbial inactivation is first measured at constant temperature. This is usually followed by observing how microbial inactivation changes with temperature. For heat processing method, the main type of the heat treatment you now be covered the namely of the pasteurization and sterilization. This is for the name of pasteurization is from the person who can know file the file is the folder for the method for using the this method for destroy the bio microorganism is Louis Pasteur. The pasteurization is come from his name. For pasteurization, the first one. First, pasteurization is a mild heat treatment which is used on wide range of different type of food production. The two primary aims of pasteurization are to remove pathogenic bacteria from food, thereby preventing disease, and to remove spoiled or starving bacteria to improve its keeping quality. A process such as pasteurization can be done batch-wise and continuously. Batch processing involves filling in the vessel, heating, holding, cooling, and emptying in the vessel, filling into container and clean the vessel. Holding time may be up to about 30 minutes. Okay, not too fast, right? It's okay, okay. I will go next. Okay, the first one is bat pasteurization. Use a bat pasteurizer, which consists of a jacket that's surrounded by either circulating water with added steam or heating coil of water or direct steam. It is the simplest and the oldest method for pasteurizing with heated to 63 degrees Celsius. A large container and held that at the temperature for 30 minutes is called this process as long temperature and long time process. This process can be carried out at home off stove top using a large pot or at a small scale of another pot with steam heated kettle and fancy temperature control equipment with the same theory, like temperature will be heat up to 63 degrees Celsius and holding time for 30 minutes, then cooling immediately for prevent from the spoiled bacteria that will grow at the temperature of 40 to 55 degrees Celsius is called spoiling bacteria. For pathogenic bacteria will best grow at 30 to 37 degrees Celsius. And it show the home cooking one that you can do the bat pasteurize at the left side of the picture. And the right side is for the commercial batch pasteurization.
Hi James, this is our process of making milk. This is Davide. Pouring the milk from the vat, gravity fed. This is the noise of the vat while it's heating. This is the noise. because it's heating very hot.
Consistency of the heat, and this is a batch pasteurization. And for the next video, in batch also, but in batch with automatic milk pasteurization. For example, you can change cow milk to a rice drink, rice food. With the same milk. Continuous operation is called the high temperature short time for offer the number of advantages such as faster heating and cooling rates, shorter holding times, and regeneration, which save both heating and cooling costs and contribute to the low processing costs incurred the thermal processing operation compared to with many novel techniques. It is the most common method for today, especially for higher volume of processing. This method is faster and more energy efficient than batch pasteurization, though the higher temperature may give the milk slightly cooked flavor. High temp, short time is about 75 degrees Celsius for only 15 seconds. And has been used for so long that many people are used to the flavor. Okay, this is for example of the rice meal rice drink pasteurization. The left one is rice batch pasteurization that you can do it like home cooking. And for the right one is for the machine that you will can be an auto pack on also. Be the manual packing rice drink product. The right one is jasmine rice drink.
Okay, clear? 8 new of light.
Yeah. Sterilization. This is can be both of a UHT process or ultra high temperature process. The sterilized in this food process almost sterilized liquid food by heating above 135 degrees Celsius or 275 degrees Fahrenheit. The temperature required to kill many bacterial endospores. The heat used during the UST process can cause Maillard reaction and change the taste and smell of the products. So it can keep longer, but it also have the effect on smell and color of the product also. For the example one is from the raspberry rice product. It's rice meal from raspberry rice product. It's Thai product. Does it making by the process of UHT? Yeah, it's for the process roughly for the making the pasteurized rice germ milk. Process of rice germ meal. The first one we start from rice germ and then soaking, blending with water with the ratio of 1:2. Right, the rice is 1, the germ rice, the rice is 1 and the water is 2. Filter. Yes, and for the to get the residual. And the residue will be to the animal feed. So from after filter, we will get the raw rice germ milk, right? After that, we'll go to pasteurize. Anyway, you can do it pasteurized by high temp short time or low temp long time, any method that you can do it. So for aseptic filling with hot filling. So cooling immediately for remove or protect or prevent the spoiling bacteria and store it in the refrigerator at 4 degrees Celsius. It's like a home cooking that you can do it. You can try to do it. Just show the technique of pasteurization, not focus on the cow milk. Yeah. Show you the technique of the pasteurization. We have the method like this, have the procedure like this to kill the bacteria or the process of the and for the next method is retort for doing canned food. Right. The first one, I will explain this about that. It is the pressure vessel used in the food manufacturing industry to commercially sterilize food after it has been placed into the container and the container has been hermetically sealed. More on commercial sterilize later. The method of sterilization is a thermal based process or the application of high heat to the product. The high temperature required in a sterilization process destroys pathogenic organisms that may be present in or on the container and or food product, and is well above the boiling point of water at normal atmospheric pressure. So the retort is by design a pressure vessel. Thermal processing or sterilization of shelf-stable, low-acid food with a finished equilibrium pH greater than 4.5 and water activity greater than 0.85 is usually performed at temperature at or above 121 degrees Celsius. The higher temperature, the shorter time of the product need to be exposed to heat. This process will can flexible by the personal head you can train for the retort supervisor. Has to control with the retort supervisor if the factory or the rice mirror has to do this process. So you have to have at least retort supervisor. One retort supervisor to control all the process of this method. For example, is rice can or canned rice? Okay, this is more value added. That you can change the rice that cooking from rice cooker is to be the canned rice. It's more easy to carry. For example, is easy to keep or store it. Like for they have the disaster calamity, right? Flooding or something like that. You can have this one and to help you for food supply. And this is also for the process of canned rice. Yeah, you have to have rice first and water and mixing it, like pre-cook it first, then to the step of canning, exhausting, steaming, simmer, like to cover the product immediately. And to the process and the retort machine. So after the retort machine will be cooling, drying, labeling, and storage. The product will be stored for 2 years. It's about 2 years. The can rice could be to be kept about 2 years, not more than that. Yeah. And this is more value added than at pressure to present about Thai food and a little bit Chinese applied food. The first one is called khao lam. You know khao lam from Thailand? Nong Mon. Khao lam is a glutinous rice with coconut milk roasted in the bamboo. The original one is on the left. So how to eat? You have to use the hammer to for the content of rice meal and milk, animal meal is different in content. For the rice meal is about vitamin and mineral, but in is more than the animal meal, that's higher in protein and calcium. The different type, the different the nutrient to compare with the animal milk. Okay. Continue for the product value added.
Okay, thanks.
Is canned rice ready ready to eat?
Yeah, ready to eat. You can open it and then eat. The triangle made rice. Wajang, yes. You know wajang? From? Oh, no, wajang. It's, in Chinese, it's zhongju.
Delicious.
Okay, you can try. So this is the like to make over the product by the chef, by the container. Yeah. From the batang is the glutinous rice steamed in bamboo leaf with pyramid shape wrapping. From the website is the original one. And for the rice size is the modern form of the batang. You see? Ah, it look interested? More interested?
Yes.
I need all recipe. Okay, have two.
Recipe.
Okay, I will tell you by email because it's the products of the entrepreneurs that have to work to give the allowance from the company, okay?
เดี๋ยวไปเอาของจริงมาให้ที่โรงงานนะคะ
Okay, thanks, bye.
Okay, for the next technology is chilling and freezing. Chef for preserve food by lowering temperature. We have according to the two types of the growing process. The first one is chilling and the second one is freezing. For the first one is chilling. Chilling is the process technique in which the temperature of food is reduced and kept in the temperature between this around 4 degrees Celsius. To describe the refrigeration process and make the temperature decrease product. Yeah. And this for the rice, we have rice in the chilling in the market in Thailand. It's called a rice chill product. You can reheat it and already and like to instant rice, you can reheat it and can eat after that. The storage time is about 5 to 7 days. For freezing, we also have the product that become the freezing rice. Yeah. From the freezing is one of the oldest and most widely used method of the preservation. The freezing process is kind of a combination of the beneficial effects of low temperature with microorganisms cannot grow. Chemical reactions are reduced and cellular metabolic reactions are delayed. The technique one that I will show you is air blast freezing. Air blast freezing is common freezing technique used through the world to freeze various food, combine the combination of crackers to package food. It is a special kind of freezer used to keep food safely at varying temperature in order to prevent microorganisms from forming and growing. So the blast freezer can normally reduce food temperature from degrees Celsius to minus 18 degrees Celsius within 4 hours. This is the picture of a brass freezer. And then the video will show the how the a brass freezer works. about 2 years also. But the recipe and the amount of ingredient, I have to tell you later because I have to have a permission or allowance from the factory that I be a consultant at there first. Okay. Okay, for the frozen ice cream rice will be in the flow of this. And this is the packaging and this is the look of the frozen rice cream. That will be use the process of a glass freezer. For drying technology is the old method of food preservation. This goal is achieved by reducing the available moisture and water activities. And the first one starts from sun dry. The easiest way to process and extend the shelf life of the food. Yeah, for the Thai menu. This is called hao tan. It's made from, it's all in English is cracker rice. It's made from by using the glutinous soaking in the water for 2 or 4 hours and keep it in the mold, the circle mold, and then let them to the sun dry for 1 day. And then keep it from drying and then deep fry the cracker and then decorate it with coconut sugar. And you can modify to be like cracker, like macaron. You can fill it up with stuff, creamy stuff, jam, like, and use it, the cracker in substitute to the macaron dough, like in the picture on the right side. Dumb dryer. For dumb drying, is the method used for drying out of liquid from raw material, which is using the dumb dry. The dumb dry composed of the two cylinder, which the one with two. The first one is you rotate in the clockwise, and another one is anti-clockwise. So the method and I will show you in this is for the products that made from the dumb dryer technique. This is called instant congee and the dumb dry video. And then you get the dry plate of the rice, the plate, you take it off, the plate, and then you see the dry plate. This is instant rice that you only put hot water in
the pan,
Okay, this is product that made from dumb dryer, Thai product also. The red one is from the raspberry rice, and for the right one is old jasmine rice. For the fermentation technique, the last technique for today, last but not least. So, fermentation is the ancient technique. For Thai, only have the, in Thai is called khama. That's for preserved food and more value added for rice. Khama, in English, is fermented rice. It made from using sticky rice. For sticky rice, sticky rice or rice with to fermented with a baldo. Baldo is consists of yeast and bacteria. It's good for fermenting. Yeah, and mix it together and put it in the container with a little bit released air. So about 3 or 4 days, we will get the kalma for eating. For more variety, when you cook, you can add color from the natural light, pandanus for more aroma about pandanus also. This called kalma in Thailand is from the fermented rice. Okay. Another product from rice fermentation is the rice. The left one is rice vinegar, and the rice one is rice cider. Okay, this is a home cooking method. You can do it. This method is the most easiest way that you can do it by yourself at home. The first one is salad dressing for rice, from rice, berry rice. You will get the salad dressing with healthy from the rice, berry rice. The ingredient will be in sugar, vinegar, pepper, mustard, sweet condensed milk, salt, cooked rice, berry rice, oil, water. And the instruction will be on this side. Rice, like jasmine rice, white rice, you can add something like this, like orange juice, Brazil juice, or passion fruit juice for more color and more aroma and more taste about this kind of salad dressing. In for the doing this like this kind of salad dressing, you have to pasteurize before because you have egg in this ingredient. So for another one is the ice cream from raspberry rice. Yes, this is an ingredient and the instruction of doing it. You can do it for all these tea menus by yourself at home. This is like from the main raw material is from the degraded rice and the cooked rice that you left from your meal. Okay, this is all presentation for today about the product development of rice. Okay, and I think that first of all, I have to say thank you for your attention for 2 days, like yesterday and today morning part. If you have any questions, you can leave the message for me again, and I will reply you via email. Okay, for today, thank you for your attention and. So, okay. Thank you for your attention.
Okay. Thank you very much, Purita Kwananan, for a very informative lecture for today of the rice mill development for making the new products from the supply chain of the rice. This is the question and answer again, like yesterday. If you have any question, feel free to text the message to the chat message so that we can learn together what is your vision. And today there are about 70 people around the world joining us for this room. May I request your kind cooperation to open your video camera so that we can have a chance to see you throughout our school application, and we keep it for our record and our memory to be revised as during we develop the next project. Are there any questions from our colleagues and friends regarding this lecture of the rice field product development? Feel free to ask the questions. Ah, yes, from Myanmar colleagues. Can, oh, what is that? Pasteurization to expert because
machine
this produce alpha toxin. Very chemical issue.
I'm emailing you for the answer because he has to explain about a bit more time.
This can kill or cannot kill
which species of Aspergillus? The first question from the two. Which species? We have many species of Aspergillus. We have too many different types for killing.
For example, can you give the example of the species?
Clay was. Which produce alpha toxin? As I told you yesterday, the alpha toxin is a chemical that created from the bacterium. So the chemical cannot destroy. So we have to kill first the Aspergillus. Have to control, not destroy at all. Control in the amount of the limitation, and so it cannot produce the toxin to harm ourselves.
Okay. Thank you for inviting a nice lecture. Oh, I see many faces around the world. Yeah, with different times of hello. Oh, from which species of rice could rice meal be extracted?
Every species.
Are you clear? From Egypt of Duma Asumi?
In the ratio of optimum.
It depends on the ratio, I see. Yes, clear, thanks. Anyone who like volunteer to, I ask for volunteer to show your experience or your study or your research about the product development by making from the rice, anyone? You need to request for microphone. Before we move to that, is there any mycotoxin in rice bran oil? This question quite really
complex.
So maybe could we have you
answer you again and reply the email.
But actually, we hope that you can have the chance to taste the sea rice in the banana leaf in the vegetable chair. That also my favorite product, my rice as well. Okay. If you have any questions or any opinion or any discussion regarding on the product development, we could bring up on another. Feel free to email her at the email in the material that we already sent to you by our QR link and QR code. Okay. Our next lecture will be the rice meal development by the packaging development. You are sitting with us for continuous activities to be with the next lecturer, Dr. Panuwasakun from Kasisa for Agriculture University in Thailand. Before we start the next activity, may I ask for a short break, about 10 minutes, for you to make a refreshment. After 10 minutes, we will come back to the next lecture, and it would be the last lecture for this training course. At this moment, we thank you very much for your kind cooperation for participating in this lecture. Okay, ขอบคุณ means thank you very much, Ms. Purita Poranan, to be with us for today. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Welcome back everyone to our study. I hope we enjoy our food festival that we demonstrate for your appreciation that you attend our course, and we hope next time you could visit Thailand and enjoy our festival. Continue to our lecture number 8. And you will be last lecture for today is the value added in rice meal package development. To be with us today, Dr. Phanuwat Sapakun from Kasetsart University in Thailand. As I told you, Kasetsart means agriculture. He obtained the Bachelor of Science in Agricultural Packaging Development from Kasetsart University and Master of Science in Agricultural Packaging Development as well in Australia, and after that obtained the doctoral degree in packaging technology from Victoria University from Australia. Dr. Phanuwat is very keen and active and intelligent in the packaging, edible means and coating for food industry. He also invests in the smart packaging, active and intelligent packaging, edible coating and film, polymeric packaging, mass transfer parameter and application in shelf life of food products. He has various publications, journal, research, and academic report, and also he get many rewards from his academic activities, and also got registered for the patents in packaging development. And now, Dr. Phanuwat Sapakun is a professor at the packaging development department in Kasetsart University. Participants, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for our lecture? Please welcome Dr. Phanuwat Sapakun. Good morning,
Dr. Phanuwat. Good morning.
Welcome to our training course.
Okay, thank you very much for your kind introductions. Good morning from Bangkok for all participants. Today, I'd like to give a talk in the topic of value added in rice meal package development. For this, actually, this is the last lecture for this training course, right? Okay, I will give you some idea and snapshot in the area of the package development related to rice-based products. Our presentations will be include packaging overview, selected packaging converting, selected conventional packaging, and selected smart packaging. This one is a new area. And then I will come up with the concluding remark. Okay, let me start with packaging overview. Okay, for the first one, let me give you some idea about the packaging function first. For the packaging function, actually they have two main functions. It's called the major functions and minor functions. For the major functions, it's include for the protection, communications and informations, containment, machine abilities, and utility and convenience. For the packaging design, actually is a part of the integrated marketing strategy, right? And this is important as a vehicle for communications and branding. Let me give you some idea about the packaging designs first. For the packaging design, actually is included with three things. The first thing is the geometric design. For this geometric design is deal with the all dimensions from the primary package to the transport package. For example, in this picture, you can see for the primary package is the wine bottles and will be contained in the corrugated box for the secondary package and then to transportation package. For the geometric design, we deal with the all dimensions of the packaging construction. And the second one is the structural design. For the structural design is deal with all the combined data, form, environment, products, and the packaging materials all come including with okay, this one is a structural design, right? This one, I just show you some the material from the aseptic package construction, and we will show you later in this aseptic packaging for the rice mill. Okay. And for the graphic design, this graphic design is all contain all the all element, including the brands, differentiations, identities, and marketing all design. Okay. This will just show you some the beverage for the drinking that in the coffee design form the glass bottles for the metal cans and the composite material, even for the PET bottle. And this one just show you for the rice cracker that we change some the packaging design. It can increase the sales up to 20%. And this for, I will show you for consumer crew. Actually, this packaging can be consist of the all structural, graphics, and verbal design as well. And it serves as the consumer crew. Let's see this figure. For this consumer crew, for this margarine products, you can see in the left-hand side is the gold margarine, and the right-hand side is the light. And you can see in the light, the letter actually is the lit up, is light mean for the lightness of this margarine. Okay, now let me give you some idea about the re-selected packaging converting that related to some kind of the rice package development. The first thing is about the glass bottle forming, and this one can show you for the bro and bro forming. I will just give you some idea like this. And this one just for the plastic cup forming. Normally for the the set yogurt, we can prepare the plastic material by using the injection molding. Like this figure. And this one just show you for the stretch bro molding. For the stretch bro molding is deal with the like a PET bottle. Normally we can start with the preform for the PET plastic, and then this preform can be put in the mold, and by using the stretch and blow with the air, we can get the PET bottle. And this one for the tough forming, for the vacuum thermoforming, we can prepare like the PET the thermoform tray or tub for the frozen food or the chilled food. And this one for the plastic film forming, for the bro films extruding, we can use this the bro films extrusion to bro the films and can get the pouch. Sorry. Okay, for the next one is the cast film extruding. Actually, for the cast film extruding, we can use the slip extrusion to prepare the cast film. And this one is a bro film core extrusion. It means that all the film, they have more than two layer, like a multi-layer films. And this one is the cast film co-extruding. And sometimes we can use these films laminate with another layer by using the extrusion laminating to get some barrier properties of the packaging material. Like this figure, you can see this called the multi-layer flexible packaging films. In this multi-layer, in each layer they have some properties can enhance the properties of the packaging material or packaging films to protect the qualities of the food products. Okay, now let me show you some the selected conventional the packaging. Before we go for the conventional packaging, let's see this model actually deal with the food spoilage and deteriorations. For the basic model, we have the environment. For example, light, temperatures and humidities. And we have the second one for the packaging. This can protect from the environment to can keep the high quality of the food products or can enhance the shelf life of the food products. All the type of the values added, rice-based product deteriorations is include all the things that I show you in this slide. For example, microbial spoilage, oxidative rancidity, and enzymatic browning, these correlations of moisture transfer, moisture gain, moisture loss, and even for the mechanical damage. Okay, now let's go for the conventional packaging. The first thing I will show you is the air packaging. For the air packaging, actually it's very simple and we can use as the for the SME, for the small and medium enterprise. In this air packaging, the process we can use with the normal the atmosphere is used. For example, in the normal atmosphere is contained oxygen around 21%, nitrogen 78%, and it contains the minor of the carbon dioxide and argon. Okay, in this figure, just show you for rice grain. In this rice grain, actually packed in the perforated PET is polyethylene terephthalate boiled in bag, and this perforated boiled in bag is contain rice grain and can packed in OPP / LDPE pouch. For the OPP is stand for oriented polypropylene and laminate with LDPE low density polyethylene. So in these products, we can cook this which with the boiling bag, put in the hot waters, okay, and we can cook this to get the steam rice. Okay,
there is a question from our management professor, from our Niger representative said, how many packaging material or types that used to process rice in the bag? How many packaging type?
Oh, I think it's so many type. Said I try. Let me give you some all these conventional packaging first, and then after my presentation, you can ask me. Okay. After that, you can see how so get the idea from the presentation first. Okay. Okay. For this conventional one for the air packagings. When I give you some this idea, I will show you some products related to this packaging material, okay? Because with only 1.5 hours, I cannot give you some all informations, you know, in this one. Okay, for the second one, for the product that we can use with the air packaging is the flour. It's like a light flour. We can pack in the beach craft paper bag, or even for the LDPE pouch, low density polyethylene. And this one, the another product for the dry rice noodle, we can put, pack in the LDPE pouch or even in OPP pouch, is the oriented polypropylene. And even for the rice, a white rice noodle, we can pack in the LDPE pouch and put in the paper folding carton with the window with the PS is a polystyrene, because it's polystyrene have the very transparency, so we can see the products inside very well. And this one for the instant rice vermicelli noodle, actually this one for the noodle we can pack with the OPP or MOPP pouch. For the MOPP pouch, it stands for metallized oriented polypropylene. It means that we use OPP, we metallize with the aluminum vapor to increase the high barrier material of this packaging. It means that we can extend the shelf life better than the OPP pouch. For the another one is for the PP cup. This one is polypropylene cup with the MOPP lid, I mean the lifting films. And this one just show you for the instant rice porridge. For this one actually is the dry powder, so we can pack with the PET, polyethylene tetraethyl laminate with the aluminum foil and laminate with the LDPE pouch as the heat sealant layer. And for the frozen meal, this one just show you some kind of product with the organic rice berry or organic rice berry with the Thai style curry, chicken curry. We can pack this one in the tray with the CPT, is the cast polyethylene tetraethyl thermoform tray with the coated PET LDPE lifting frames and pouch. Okay, let me move to the second packaging. Conventional packaging is the vacuum packaging. For this vacuum packaging, the process actually we can use the atmosphere without the package. It means that we have to remove all the air content in the inside the package or in the air space. In this picture, just show you for we pack the rice grain with the vacuum pack. You can see for the actually for the packaging material for the rice grain, the suitable one actually is the MLLDPE laminate with OPA and LLDPE. Okay, I will send. Will show you. For the MLLDPE, it stands for metallocene linear low density polyethylene laminate with the oriented poly MI. Actually, it's nylon, and then laminate with the linear low density polyethylene. Why we need to use the linear low density polyethylene for the rice grain? Because this LDPE actually is the high puncture strength. Because the rice grain actually has the, it's like a needle, so it can cause for the local rice spread to make the bag can break out. That's why we have to use the high puncture strength, this one of material, to resist with the strength of the rice grain. And then when we pack with the our vacuum packaging, and then we can keep in the folding carton as well. Okay, for the next one is the gas flushing packaging. For this process, actually the atmosphere we can replace with individual gas. Normally actually is the nitrogen, because the nitrogen actually is the inert gas. So we have to replace the air content in the air space with the nitrogen. This one can retard the lipid oxidations of the product. For example, with the snack food, that the process with the deep fry, with the fat deep fry. Okay, for the rice grain, actually in this nitrogen flushing, we can pack rice grain as well with the OPP/LLDPE pouch. Or for the rice cracker, we use the OPP slash with the LDPE pouch in this case. And this one, in the left hand side, actually we use the OPP pouch and we pack inside with the paper folding cartons. And the right hand side actually is the OPP pouch with the OPP pouch actually at the single, in the single pack. And then we put this all maybe 6 packs in this packaging with the OPP, PE, MPET and LLDPE pouch. And this one, for the rice cracker with the pork or squid frost. Okay, because this one is very premium products, so we can use OPP with the aluminum foil to keep the high quality of this product and can extend the shelf life maybe more than 6 months to a year for this type of products. And this product we put in with the stand-up pouch with the zip bag. Another one for the nitrogen flushing, actually we can apply with the cooking rice bran oil. Like in this case, for the cooking oil, contain very high concentrations of the oleosanol. This oleosanol actually is an antioxidant. It's very healthy for the consumer. So this kind of packaging actually is the PET bottle, polyethylene terephthalate. Another one is the rice bran oil spray. For the rice bran oil spray, actually we can pack in the polystyrene thermoform tub. So we can use replace with the layer butter, because this rice bran oil spray is very healthy for the consumer, better than the butter. Okay, for the next packaging actually is the aseptic packaging. Before this, I already show you about packaging design, the structural design thing about the composite material. This one is a like UHT bag package or tetra pack. So this tetra pack or this product will apply with the aseptic packaging. For the aseptic packaging system, actually we have to do 3 things. The first thing, we have to sterilize the product first, and then we have to sterilize the packaging material. And 2 things is come up with in the chamber with the condition is a aseptic condition. So that's why we call aseptic packaging. And this one just show you for aseptic carton packaging. As you can see, for the multi-layer in this UHT pack. Inside actually is the LDPE. For the LDPE, we use as the high sealant layer. And we have the aluminum foil. And this aluminum foil can have the very high barrier materials. And we have the paper board. And the outside, we have the printing layer for the graphic designs. As you can see, with this kind of the packaging material, so we can prepare the aseptic food products and can keep longer for a year, you know, for a year and storage at the ambient condition. This one just show you some kind of the UHT rice meal. That's some kind of the products from the rice meal for the value-added. You can see this kind of product we have used the packaging material from the LDPE paperboard, aluminum foil, and the LDPE. And this structure we call tetra prisma. Its structure is look like a prism, so that's why I call the prisma. The next one is the aseptic thermoform packaging. And this aseptic thermoform packaging we can apply. Sorry, maybe the slide. Okay, this one, sorry. Okay, for the thermoform tray aseptic, we can apply with the this PP thermoform tray with the chill mill. In Thailand, from the CP with the brand Isiko, they use an aseptic packaging with this kind of products and can sell these products in the convenience store and very high consumed at the moment. And here is the set rice yogurt. The product actually in the left hand side, actually this the products from the Italy. They use the PP polypropylene injections molding tub. But in the right hand side actually is the products from Thailand. And these use the LDPE laminate with the polystyrene thermoform tub. And this kind of the set yogurt, the base from the rice yogurt actually. The next one is the hot filling. For the hot filling, actually, we have to sterilize the products, I mean the liquid first, maybe up heat to 194 degrees Celsius prior to the hot filling. And then we have to do immediately cooling. These high products can keep longer for 6 to 12 months and fit well with the non-carbonated beverage. This one just kind of the products we use with the hot fillings. In the left hand side is from the Thailand, from the rice mill. But in the right hand side, actually this product from Japan, from the rice brown mill. Actually we use with the gas bottle with the metal cap or easy open cap. Another packaging is the retort packaging. Actually for retort packaging, we have to move the process from the food canning or sterilizations to the retort packaging. Actually for the retort packagings, we have the structure of the material consists of the PET laminate with the aluminum foil and nylon. Actually nylon is a polyamide. And then for the insulator layer is the CPP. It stands for cast polypropylene. Why we have actually this structure maybe is looks like for the aseptic packaging, but this retort packaging have to fill the product first and then we have to do sterilizations. That's why the heat sealant layer we have to use CPP class polypropylene, because polypropylene have the melting point higher than 122 degrees Celsius. So it means that this material can stand for the temperatures and the pressure inside the retort. So this type of product actually have the shelf life up to 2 years. However, actually we can do an optimal packaging for this retort packaging by change the structure of the aluminum foil to other type of the high barrier material for the shelf life requirement that we want. Okay, this I'll just show you just some kind of the products that we use with retort packaging is the steam rice. In this case, we have the rice put in the polypropylene tray with the oriented polypropylene slab with the CPP lifting films, and we have to pack it first and then bring this put in the retort, and we can do sterilization, we can get the steam rice, and we can put this on the shelf at the ambient condition. And this one, another type of the products in Thailand is the ready meal rice congee. For the congee, they use with the retort pouch with the PET, aluminum foil, nylon, and CPP stand up pouch. Okay, this one, another one of the retort packaging for the ready meal rice congee. For this ready meal, as you can see, this kind of box is a look like with the UHT rice meal that I already showed you before, right? But I already give you some idea for the retort packaging. As you can see, for the heat sealer layer inside this package, the layer actually is the polypropylene layer that I told you before. This polypropylene have the high melting point, so that's why it can stand the high temperature, you know, in the retort. Okay, now let me move to another section for the smart packaging. So for the conventional packaging, if we move to the smart packaging, how can we deal with the value-added rice meal packaging development? Okay, let's see this slide first. For this slide, as you can see, I showed you before the major functions of the packaging. For the protection functions, as you can see, for the smart packaging actually consists of two things. Is the active packaging and intelligent packaging. For the active packaging actually is to enhance the protection functions, whereas intelligent packaging is enhance communications and information function. Actually, they have so many types of the active packaging and so many types of the intelligent packaging. However, in this case, deal with the rice-based products, or I will show you just some select type that can apply with this kind of product. For instance, the oxygen scavenging. For the oxygen scavenging, actually, is a packaging system that require oxygen scavenging activities. So it means that this oxygen scavenging sachet will scavenge the oxygen inside the package or in the airspace, and then it will be delay or prevent the oxidation reactions or to minimize the microbial growth, and then it can extend the storage life of the product. As you can see in this figure, actually is the pizza crust. So this pizza crust we apply with the oxygen scavenging sachet, it can keep the products very well without the mold growth when compared with the control. It means it without the oxygen scavenging sachet. Okay, this figure I just showed you for the rice based products that apply with the oxygen scavenging sachet. This product actually is the pounded the undried rice snack. In Thai we call khao mi. Actually in this product we keep in the pouch with the OPP PET RLDPE zip stand up pouch. But in this case, this product they add up with smart packaging with the oxygen scavenging sachet. As you can see at the bottom of this package, we can see in the right the green color actually is the oxygen scavenging sachet, and this sachet you can scavenge the oxygen in this hair space. So it means that without oxygen, this kind of product can delay the lipid oxidation for this kind of the products. It's in Kamami. It means that can extend the shelf life or longer. So for this smart packaging, actually we have to apply with the premium product first, because they have to add up with more cost to the packaging. Okay, for the second one, for the intelligent packaging, I will show you for the ready-to-serve indicator or RSI. For the ready-to-serve indicator, in this case, actually is the packaging system for the material that use environment as the information to monitor the serving status. As you can see in the right-hand side, remember I show you this kind of the package we call Tetra Prisma, because it looks like a prism. Actually this one is the UHD or aseptic packaging. For this product actually is the orange juice or the beverage. As you can see in the middle with the logo with the penguin, it actually is when the penguin is inside, the temperature is right. So as you can see the figure of the penguin, in the blue color. Actually, this one is a thermochromic ink, and this type ink can sense with the temperature of the environment. It means that if we bring this tetraprisma, the package, put in the refrigerator, fit in the fridge, when the temperatures go down, and then come to the chill condition, this thermochromic ink will change the color from colorless to the blue color. So when we see the penguin figure, it means that this one is ready to serve for the consumer already. Okay, let's see in the right hand side. For the right hand side, actually is the maple syrup. Okay, actually for the maple syrup, we have to serve with the waffles, maybe in the fast food, right? Like in this case for the Hungry Jack. Actually in this figure, as you can see, we have to print with the normal ink, with the letter with the hot, H-O-T, and then we print a power with the thermochromic ink with the black color. So when we bring this into the microwave for the heating, what is going on? And then when it's, the temperature is up, this thermochromic ink in the black color will rise up to the colorless. So that's why we can see the hot letter come out. So that's why it's just show the consumer to know that now it's ready to serve for the hot waffle and the breakfast for you. Okay, in this case, because I don't have the case for the rice meal, so this one's just some kind of product in Thailand. Actually, it's launched last year. It's the soy meal with the ready-to-serve indicator. And this soy meal actually with the flavor, with the mango flavor. As you can see in the left-hand side, we keep this one at the ambient condition of the room temperatures. And we bring this bottle, put in the refrigerator. As you can see in the labels, underneath the label, you can see the color change from the white color to the blue color. Because this one is the thermochromic ink, we can change color, you know, when we keep this one at the chill condition. So it means that we can apply this kind of packaging material in terms of intelligent packaging for ready-to-serve indicator for the rice meal bottle as well. Okay, and in this case, I just show you, actually this product actually from the Korea, South Korea. This one is the instant noodle with the ready-to-serve indicator. As you can see, this noodle, they're packed in the polypropylene cup with the leading film, aluminum foil leading films. And you can see in the aluminum foil leading films, they're printed with the thermochromic ink with the dark green color. So when we open it and put the hot water and just hover back, just leave for maybe 4 minutes. And you can see the color of the dark green color will change to the bright green color. It's just told the consumer to know that now it's ready to serve, you know, to eat this instant noodle. Okay, now come to the concluding remarks. So for this presentations, I will give you some the idea for the selected packagings, conventional packagings that evolve with the provide the majors and minor function for the value-added rice-based product quality. And for the smart packaging, I will show you how they can enhance the protection function, how they can enhance the communications or information functions for the consumer via the active and intelligent packaging. And this rice-based product, it deals with the oxygen scavenging sachets and ready-to-serve indicator, respectively. And this kind of value-added rice-based product and packaging development actually is can offer the new business opportunities for the rice meal factories, and thus can fit to the broad realm with the food industry transformation 5.5. Okay, Thank you very much for your kind attention for my presentations. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask, please.
Thank you very much, Dr. Thanguan, for very comprehensive for the packaging development into the rice mill factory. Not only rice, but also another kinds of food products that supply chain from rice as well. We have learned for the technology that we are packaging for the food and rice before we eat it and before we sell it into the supermarket. So anyone of us would like to have some questions? During the lecture, there is a question about the environmental. From our Nigerian, Mr. Benjamin asked, how environmental friendly are your packaging materials? How environmental friendly your packaging materials, because I think maybe most of the packaging made from the chemical products.
Okay. Actually, as you can see from now on, all this kind of product has been sales in the market. Actually, in the market, actually is based on the synthetic packaging material, especially for the plastic material, right? Anyhow, for the next phase of the industry, actually, when we learned, you know, even from the university, now we have to do a research, you know, to change, you know, from the synthetic packaging plastic material to the bio-based packaging material. More and more will come out to the market. Even for at the moment, as you can we can tell you that even for the reading film with the synthetic plastic material, now we can change to the bio-based packaging material is polylactic acid laminate with the PBAT, polybutyrene adipate material, we call the PBAT. Actually, this kind of leading film with a very high transparency, we can replace with the conventional one as well.
Okay, thank you very much for your answer. The next question during the lecture from our Niger, Mr. Fordy, asking on the maybe specific study, how many packaging materials or types that are used to pack processed in rice?
In Thailand. Normally, if we divide the packaging material, we can divide that by the type of the material. We can divide into glass packaging, metal packaging, plastic packaging, even for the composite packaging, right? Actually, in this case, for the house, so many types, they have so many, we call the varieties, even especially for the plastic packaging. Actually, it depends on your products, and it depends on the packaging material properties. We can do like tailor-made, tailor-made to get the optimal packaging for your products. It means that some kind of product, especially in Japan, normally in Japan, we can see that some kind of products is they use so many kind of the high-end material. It means that we call over-packaging. Even some kind of product in the developed country or developing country, for the product, for example, in Thailand, in the northern Thailand, we have the crispy skin pork, right? We just keep this in the LDPE material. This one we call the under-packaging. Because LDPE material and we pack with the air packaging, this kind of product is the process actually is the deep fry with the cooking oil, right? And when we pack with the air packaging in the air that contain the oxygen, right? So when we pack it, we didn't remove the oxygen. It means that you can keep this kind of product is very short time. So that's why we call it under packaging. So actually in the reality, actually we have to study the products. We have to study the packaging material and then we can design the packaging material that serve for individual products.
Okay, thank you very much.
actually.
Okay, thank you very much. It's very clear. So that before we think about the packaging, so we have to study of the product first.
Absolutely.
What kind of the product? What kind of the life chain of the
absolutely
product? And we have to select the right material to suit for
yes
that of product. Maybe continuing to this question, our Indian colleagues have any packaging recommendation for the rice bound product?
Rice bound, this is a rice grain, right? This is a grain.
Okay,
grains, right? Rice bound. Actually, I already show you because normally for the grains, right, they have the very, very strong, it's like a needle. So that's why normally we pack in the just normal bag like the LDPE. Because the LDPE, with the strength of the LDPE actually is less than the LDPE. LDPE stands for linear low density polyethylene. This linear low density polyethylene have the high puncture resistance. It means that when do a vacuum packaging with rice brown grain, what happened? This the surface of the packaging material will do a surface contact with the rice grain, right? And this rice grain has this like a noodle, like a puncture needle, right? So they have the localized strain is happened. So it means that if this kind of material cannot stand with this localized strain, what happened? The packaging material will be break out. So that's why we have to use with the LDPE for the rice grain, actually. LDPE stand for linear low density polyethylene.
Okay, that might be for the question from our Indian colleagues asking for the material that maybe suit for the bar rice. Yeah. Next question, in your address, yeah, later on our staff will give the address of the Dr. Fanua for the elaboration. Maybe about the percentage or the ratio of the cost should be limited to the material, because our neighbor was asking about. Because if you are more concentrate on the packaging, maybe if you increase the cost of the product, so how much percent of the total cost of the material that we have to consider when we are doing produce one product like the rice maybe or steam rice, for example, the cost of the production of the material?
Actually, in my idea, this total cost of the packaging maybe should not it should be less than the 10%, you know, from the product cost. Anyway, that's why I told you, you know, for the actually it depend on your products. If you have the you want to keep the high value added to your product, it means that you have to need more the packaging, you know, to cover, to keep the high quality of this kind of product. So it means that that's why I told you before, for the smart packaging that they use at the moment, they deal with the very premium products, like a functional food for the organic food with a very high price of the product first. Let me show you in Thailand, the first thing that we apply with the oxygen scavenging sachet with the product in Thailand actually is the mooncake. In maybe last 20 years, and this product is very successful in Thailand, because at that time for the mooncake per piece actually the price is around 70 baht, but the moment the price is around 100 to 120 baht already. So that's why this kind of product very high value. So that's why we can use with the like oxygen scavenging sachet to apply with, right? Anyhow, at the moment, because with the high cost of the this kind of the packaging material is decreased, so even in Thailand at the moment, we can see this oxygen scavenging sachet with the normal food products, even in the convenience store, it can spread more in the Thailand.
Normally, in the opinion of our professor, Manuwa said that about 10% of the material cost for the product, but if your product is more getting high level, maybe you can consider to adjust or develop the packaging into that material. Thank you very much. Next, from our colleagues from Egypt, asking what are the newest branding means in packaging field for food commodities.
What are
the newest branding? Newest branding. What that is mean is maybe our colleagues can elaborate more. Newest branding
means in packaging food.
Or maybe I think maybe the newest material or the new technology.
I'm not sure because they said newest brandings means in packaging field, right?
Yep.
Newest branding is mean that okay if you have to I'm not sure it's correct or not, right? For the newest brandings, it means that maybe if you want to launch the new the new products, right? And you have maybe some kind of the competitors. Maybe you have to do some kind of use the selection the packaging material with the new one, you know, maybe to set up, you know, your brand, you know, like a difference from your competitors. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Next will be the cost again. How much? Yeah. Is the packaging market in Thailand
estimated? I have no idea at the moment because
because he is not a businessman, he is a technician and
maybe for the National Food Institute have some in this information to give to them, right?
We will try to find the answer for that question for our Senegal for the cost of the how much packaging market in business. Next is from our Niger. What packaging are best adopted for long term storage for processed rice?
For processed rice. Normally, when we talk about the packaging, actually we don't say the best one. We just fight for the optimal one. Okay, it depends. Even if I can tell you with my experience with this one, even the same product, if you distribute to just in the like local, or in the around the like in Thailand around the Bangkok city. The packaging material that we use may be different from we distribute to my export to every corner of the world, because it depends on your shelf life requirement. Because sometimes when you distribute your products, this kind of product have to consume maybe within 1 or 2 months already finished. How can you have to keep this for 1 or a year longer? It's the way that's for the packaging cost for you, right? So that's why it depends. That's why in the industry, normally when we deal with the industry, when we do some packaging's shelf life packaging modeling for the industry, when we ask the industry how can you keep this packaging material, why you choose this one, they say that according to the supplier. Okay, this supplier sell by use this, they follow them, right? But sometimes they have to need to consult with the like packaging technologies, to do modeling to predict the shelf life, to check the price or the things, or even for the cost, totally cost, right? So sometimes I can tell that actually the industry maybe can save a lot of £1 million a year, for the packaging material, because when they order at the raw, because this is depends on what I say, it depends on the shelf life requirement that they really want.
So the market requirement, right? Also the factor that to consider,
that's right.
what types of material.
So that's why we have to call optimal packaging.
Optimal packaging.
Yeah.
So we have to study more in terms of each package. Okay, thank you very much. Next, maybe the question about very techniques for the backup for our Myanmar colleague. For rice packaging, is a way need to welcome package? Need to always pack welcome?
Okay.
And why?
Not why we have to do a welcome packaging with the rice grain. Actually, normally we do with maybe
when they'll get back in the past time, actually we deal with the packaging. And what is going on with the rice grain? Even you do a very clean process, they have the contaminant with the insects. With this insect, actually they have the insect eggs inside. And this can get a hatching easily with the air packaging because this egg, actually they require the oxygen. So that's why for the vacuum packaging, we have to remove the oxygen in the hairspray or remove the air because in this air have the contain oxygen around 21%, right? So without this oxygen, that's why we can retard for the insect hatching inside the package. So even in Europe, some product in Thailand means we export to the Europe and in they sell in the like the Asian shop market. They have some problem. Even the product from Thailand is okay, right? When we start on the shelf with the other kind of products from Asia, you know what is going on. They have some kind of the insect from other package, you know, in web into this kind of the products in Thailand. So that's why not just for the vacuum packaging, even for the now for the smart packaging, we go for the insect reappearance packaging. It means that this packaging material we have to incorporate with the insect reappearance extract. So to repel the insect like to ingress to the package. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Maybe the main reason to do welcome because of the related insect coming to
hatching. Yeah, that's right.
Okay. Thank you very much. From our single colleagues, maybe for the opinion question, do you think that one day plastic will be banned in the packaging industry?
I don't think so. You know why? Because now even we just still have the we have to consume with the vehicle with the oil, right? Because this one is the byproducts from the oil industry, right? So that's why they have to keep, of course they have to keep this one, you know, to how to apply. Anyway, maybe they can how to change the form, how can they can easily to degrade. You know, it's not like to bad with the environment. Yeah.
Okay, we still can using the material with maximize benefits
yep.
from
yep.
The petroleum industry actually. But anyway, we have to care about the environmental benefits as well.
Because without like plastic material, you will deal with the food waste as well. Otherwise, because sometimes even in Thailand, you know, in Thailand we have because we have a agricultural country, right? We have the post harvest, right? Sometimes you know in Thailand, every year we lose around 10,000 million baht, you know, for the food waste in the post harvest in Thailand as well, because we use with the like the under packaging. You know, with the fresh produce product. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much for your opinion
in
terms of the environmental friendly. Next, we will be from our Nicaragua from Latin America. Would like the professor to show any experience in Thailand with packaging of biodegradable material.
Okay. Like in for the biodegradable material that can experience in Thailand now. Now we have some kind of this kind of product. Actually, they may spawn the package. What do you call? Chan oil.
From the
sugarcane package. After they do press sugar. For the sugar cane already, this package actually with a high fiber, so they bring this one to make the biodegradable tray, and this can serve as a disposal, you know, for other utensils, you know, for the the fast food or the things in Thailand as well.
Okay, that would be the example of using the biodegradable from the sugarcane.
Yeah, that's right. And this one have been applied with the Laya National Park as well in Thailand.
I see.
Because for the National Park, they're not allowed to use the Laya plastic foam, you know, because when they put in biodegradable, that's why we have to use this biodegradable material.
Okay, thank you very much. Next, from our Indonesian participant, is it possible we use nanomaterial as one of the food packaging materials? And is it safe for food and human health?
Okay, I kind of say that, but, because actually for in terms of the properties, for the nano material actually is very, very, very good, you know, to apply with. For example, for the antioxidant, we can prepare the antioxidant, material or extract, you know, when we prepare in terms of the nano form, it can enhance the properties of this kind of material. Anyhow, in terms of the safety, I have no idea to say in this point, because they have some kind of the people to study, I mean, around the world to study in this point.
Okay, thank you very much. Well, I see a lot of messages coming to the text box. Some people asking about how many countries that we Thailand export. I'm not sure exactly, but I think all around the world we export. To you, you may have a chance to eat Thai rice already. Going back to our Egypt colleague, she means how to make a branding of the packaging. At the first question that we're talking about, how to make the branding. This one may be the marketing strategy. We can have another topic for another lecture.
Yeah, because actually, packaging actually. We call have the marketing tool. Packaging is the marketing tool. So that's why this packaging can link with the branding of the products. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. From our Philippines colleagues, how long it will last about rice when you use welcome packaging? How long? About when it was not vacuum packed, so there is difference between vacuum and non-vacuum.
One more first. How long, right? And then
how long it takes for the vacuum? And if not vacuum, how short?
Okay, actually for the vacuum, the main thing that why we have to do a vacuum, actually we want to prevent from the insect hatching. You know what I mean? But anyway, we can get for when we do a vacuum, because actually for the rice grain, it just contain the what they call the lipid oils, you know, in the rice grain as well. So for the vacuum packaging, of course, they can keep longer when compared with the air packaging. But how is longer? I think maybe 3 months, 3 or 6 months it should be okay. Yeah. But anyhow, it depends on the packaging material for use at the vacuum packaging as well. Because for the vacuum packaging, the material, if you can use the just LLDPE, when you comply with the LLDPE laminate with the nylon and LLDPE, of course, with the nylon with a high barrier material, they can keep longer, you know, for the shelf life when compared with just the LLDPE material. Yeah.
Thank you very much for your explanation about the difference between welcome and unwelcome. Our Egypt colleague Maha, could you mention example of the eco-friendly packaging types or green packaging? We show the example of degradable material.
For the okay, actually I can show you that now at the moment that are the product that I show you actually is the commercial products, and at the moment most of the commercial products maybe is the when compared with the eco-friendly maybe is very less when you compare at the moment. Anyhow, because the cost of the eco-friendly material is higher than the cost with the synthetic material at the moment. So I believe that in the future it should be better, you know, to adopt the bio-based material, you know, to apply more with the rice-based products for the commercialization. For instance, at the moment they have some kind of the research dealing with the leading films material, and with this leading film material, they're based on the bio-based or biodegradable material. For instance, PRA, polylactic acid, you know, they laminate with the PBAT, and this one is very very comparable, you know, with the synthetic material at the moment. So it means that in the future, maybe this one can be adopted, you know, to apply with the commercialized for the food industry. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Maybe some people ask, participants ask about the natural material, which is banana leaf or bamboo leaf. I would start. Can you show the example for the patients? Yeah, banana leaf very natural as the triangle or
bacha,
triangle,
bacha.
For the example in the previous lecture, asking for what is the material with the triangle between bamboo or banana leaf.
So it's
bamboo leaf,
yeah.
Not banana leaf, because they have to stay in the hot condition. Okay, thank you very much. Move down to what are the most okay. What are the mostly harmful type of packaging material in Hazard? So dangerous in terms of human health and environmental health. Mostly Hazard type of packaging. Do we still use the Hazard in the material packaging, doctor?
Actually, you know, if we talk about the hazards of the food packaging material, we have to deal with the one term is the migration. Because normally for the synthetic plastic material, before we apply to use with apply with the food products, we have to test, you know, with the migrations, and they have some kind of the standards or the things, you know, to apply with, you know, to deal with this actually. Yeah.
Okay. Are there any questions from our participants from around the world at this moment? I see none at this moment. Anyone would like to discuss or volunteer or to show your example of the packaging material that you are using in your country in terms of the rice or steamed rice or processing rice, any kinds of rice that you are dealing or experiencing with? Anyone would like to have the volunteer to show, or you are happy that we have our contents for today lecture? Okay, thanks for lecture. Okay, I think we gained some of very knowledge and very informative information from our lecturer today, Dr. Panwasakun from SSC University. Very, very honorable for our training course for today, and we gained a lot of information, very new knowledge, and we already shared experience with the patient and the discussion among the participant and lecturer. Thank you very much, and we hope that in the next future we will have a chance to discuss more with Dr. Anuwat again. And today we would like to say thank you very much to Dr. Anuwat.
Thank you very much.
Okay, participants and colleagues, you are still be with us for our team project of the lab. Today, we are not finished the training course yet. We would like to continue for about 10 minutes from now on before we adjourn the training course. Our staff will already send you the post test of this training course. There are about questions on the four topics that we already studied during our 4 days on the topic of the food security, technology of rice meal, standard for rice meal, value added in rice meal for today's lecture. So it would be very appreciated if you could fill in the post that our staff already sent you by email or in this chat box again for the post. And after reading post, there are more to evaluation. The first one is the evaluation for this training course. Only simple questions are very easy. Can you certify medium or high certify for this course so that we could develop our project in the next time. And also the evaluation from the TAIGA, our main sponsor to this course, that asking for the general purpose that you reach your requirement or not. So I will let you do the process evaluation for the course and evaluation for TAIGA evaluation for about 5 minutes, and we will continue for our course ceremony. Okay, let's enjoy our full moon loy katong during you do the test. Okay.
Please, one people is again.
ได้เช็คกล้องไงการแค่มาก่อนเยอะนี่นะพี่วันที่เสียงการขออนุญาตเมย์มาก็พี่ก็แมสใส่ท้องให้ไหม
of our training course today, and this is the smiling face of our Thailand team project. We organized this training course organized by Office of Industrial Economics in collaboration with National Food Institute in the training course of training to enhance manufacturing technology and green productivity in rice mill factory during 26 months until today, 29 January. 4 days very fast, and we coming to the last session of the closing ceremony. On behalf of Thailand Tech Project of this online international training course, supported by Thailand International Cooperation Agency or TICA, we would like to take this opportunity to express our sincere congratulations to all participants for giving us the opportunity by attending this training course. We have learned, shared, exchanged, and developed our industrial cooperation across the world. We are appreciative with all of the information, contents, experiences, recommendations, suggestions, and actively participation by our representatives from Africa, Europe, West, Middle, South, Southeast Asia, and South Pacific, and Latin America. Appreciation is also extended to all distinguished lecturers that delivered during the training course from both public, academic, and business sector. During 4 days with different time zones across the world, we are lucky that we can connect via digital technology by Zoom application. Not only in class academic lectures, we have provided you closely with us with some showcased by video presentation and question and answer in order to optimize our Thai experience of rice mill factory and the supply chain of rice development, the activity of pre, post, and evaluation activity. We would appreciate very much for your consideration and actively participation that our team project we use the result to develop our next program. Ladies and gentlemen, after this training course activity is finished, our team project still continue to operate the activity for building our cooperation via Facebook fan page, AITC OIE Rice Mill Training Course, that we hope that it would be as a platform for starting point to extend the collaboration among us in the area of food security cooperation. Once again, congratulations for the initial step of our industrial cooperation. If there were any inconvenience appear during our activities in this online training course, we would like to extend our warm regards and would like to say that we would happy to do more better. Please keep in touch among all of us AITC family. Lastly, we wish you a safe mode and stay in a good health in your country, and hope to meet you in our cooperation activity in Thailand next time. We would like to say thank you very much, and we have to say goodbye. ขอบคุณครับ
บ๊ายบาย Good boy.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. Goodbye.
Very good.
See you some other
day. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you and goodbye.